take place through the plane wall. Okay. Now K is the thermal conductivity of the given material. So we consider to be the plane wall, and K is the thermal conductivity of the material. Now when the thermal conductivity varies with temperature is linear. Okay. Try to understand. It's not a linear line. So when the thermal conductivity varies with temperature is linear, then you will get this part as T1 and T2. So at this place, what we can say that in order to calculate the rate of heat flow, I can apply the formula Q is equal to AA dT by dx, where K is the uniform thermal conductivity. For example, if I consider the homogeneous material, in a homogeneous material, the thermal conductivity remain constant throughout the material. But though it does not remain constant, but for our equation, to apply this equation, we consider to be the constant. Okay. So when we apply the heat to the one phase, phase one of the plane wall, the temperature of the wall will get changed. As the temperature will get changed, the thermal conductivity also get varies with the temperature. As the thermal conductivity is uniform throughout the material, so thermal conductivity varies with temperature is linear. So this is called a linear profile of temperature, T1 to T2. Now in case when, or I can say if the variation of thermal conductivity, if the variation of thermal conductivity with temperature is not linear. What do you mean by not linear? It means that the thermal conductivity is not linear. So I can say this. If it is not linear, it means it can have a profile of temperature like positive curve, or it can have a profile of temperature as negative curve. So it means that here your beta will be a positive. And if you have a temperature profile in this way, I can say your beta is equal to negative. And if you have a temperature profile linear, your beta will be equal to zero. So what do you mean by this? It means that if the variation of thermal conductivity with temperature is not linear, if it is not linear, means it can either have a positive curve of this. This is the positive curve. It can have a negative, a positive curve, beta will be positive. If you have a negative curve, beta will be negative. So in such situations, if you want to calculate the rate of heat flow, so the rate of heat flow will get changed. We can have to apply the formula as U is equal to AM into A dT by dx. What is the difference here? In the above equation, I had written only the K. In the below equation, your KM, where KM stand for mean thermal conductivity. Stand for mean thermal conductivity. And it can be calculated as K of mean is equal to, or K0 into 1 plus beta T. This way you have to calculate Km. It means that when your K is uniform throughout the material, then I can say your K is equal to K0 1 plus beta T. And if it is uniform, then I can say your beta is equal to 0. If your beta is 0, if I put beta as 0, your K is equal to K0. Now what is K? K is the thermal conductivity that we are talking about K0 is the it is the thermal conductivity at zero temperature. Is it clear? Now if K is variable, if K is variable at that time, you have to consider K is equal to K0 1 plus beta T. And this your beta, it can be a positive or it can be a negative. That value you can substitute here and you can get the value of K. Are you getting me? With respect to this, I can say where my K0 is equal to thermal conductivity at zero temperature. Thermal conductivity at zero temperature. If temperature is zero, K will be K0. And your beta, it can be a temperature coefficient of thermal conductivity. Is it clear? So based on this equation, this is the main equation, K is equal to K0 1 plus beta T. When you apply for your variable thermal conductivity, then you have to apply, when you have to calculate the heat flow for a variable thermal conductivity, then Q is equal to Km A into dT by dx, where Km is the mean thermal conductivity and Km is equal to K0 1 plus beta Tm, that you have to remember. So if you are taking Km, you have to consider Tm. So where Tm stands for mean temperature, which is T1 plus T2 divided by 2. That is the mean temperature. Now keeping this in mind, if you want to solve the problem of variable thermal conductivity, so if I refer to the variable part, it is written that a composite wall, first it is understood by this part what I mean to make you understand. In case of, I had put it the title as variable thermal conductivity. So under a variable thermal conductivity, if your K is uniform, it does not change throughout the material, then you can apply the rate of heat flow equation directly. Q is equal to K dT by dx. Okay, it means your K is varying linearly with temperature. Linearly temperature change ho raha hai. Okay, but it is decreasing linearly. When the K is not uniform throughout the material, it means that if the variation of K with temperature is not linear, at that time either you can have a positive curve or you can have a negative curve. So if you have a positive curve, then your beta is equal to positive. If you have a negative curve, your beta is equal to negative. And if it is linear, so beta is equal to zero. Okay. So if it is variable thermal conductivity, in that case, you can calculate the rate of heat flow by the formula K will replace with Km, A into dT by dx, where Km is the mean thermal conductivity. And the formula to calculate the mean thermal conductivity is Km is equal to K0 1 plus beta into Tm, where Tm is the mean temperature, that is the initial plus final divided by 2. Now, and the general form of K of Km is K. K is equal to K0 1 plus beta T. So for uniform, when the K remains uniform throughout the material, we have a normal way of K is equal to K0 1 plus beta T, where beta is equal to 0. Beta stands for temperature coefficient of a thermal conductivity. If I put beta 0 as here, your K is equal to K0. It means we can apply the same formula. Now, if your K is variable, if K is varying throughout the material, then the same formula, only your beta, it can be a positive, it can be a negative. Is it clear? So with respect to this formula, now we're going to apply to our composite wall. So we take one problem. A composite wall of a furnace is made with 120 mm of fire clay. I just write the given data with this. So this is the composite wall. This is your composite wall. So in this composite wall, furnace is made with 120 mm of fire clay. So this is the fire clay. and has a thermal conductivity of, you can consider is the layer A, this is the layer B. It has a thermal conductivity of layer AA and has a thickness of given to be 120 mm. That is 0.12 meter as the thickness. And 600 mm of red brick. So it is the 600 mm, so I can take it is 0.6 is the thickness for your layer B, which is of red brick. It is the red brick. And has a thermal conductivity as AB. The inside surface temperature is 125. So I can take the inside surface temperature. This is the inside surface temperature, which is to be 1250 degrees Celsius. And the outside temperature is given to be, I consider outside temperature T2 to be, or I can say T3. T3 to be 40 degrees Celsius. Determine the temperature at the layer interface. So this is your interface. I can say this is my interface. This is your interface. And they are asking to calculate the temperature at the interface. So if I consider the temperature drop take place from layer A, so layer A is the variable thermal conductivity. So it can be in a curve form, or it can be increasing curve, or it can be of decreasing curve. In that way, you can consider. So increasing curve may be ho sakta hai, or decreasing curve may ho sakta hai. And temperature and layer B, it is of variable thermal conductivity, KV. It is given in the problem, 0.8. So based on this, it is your temperature T2. So increasing curve may be ho sakta hai, it can be decreasing curve. So I can write the mean time, your KA in the problem is given to be 0.25 into 1 plus 0.0009 into T. Okay. Watt per meter, that is watt per meter degree Celsius. And the red brick temperature KB is equal to 0.8 watt per meter degree Celsius. And the surface temperature is given. And they're asking to calculate the first part, the temperature at the layer interface. So layer interface temperature is T2. And the heat loss for 1 meter square of surface wall in this. In the second part, they are asking to calculate the heat loss. Now, these are the two things that they are asking to calculate. So how we can proceed with this problem? Now, this is the uniform. This here KE is variable. How we can understand here KE is variable? Because it look like as KA is equal to A0 into 1 plus A0 into 1 plus beta T. Can you look like this way? K is equal to K0 is 0.25, 1 plus beta is 0.009 and T. So it look like the variable, the K is the thermal conductivity of variable thermal conductivity. So we can say the fire clay, it has a variable thermal conductivity. So a variable form here. And here the KB, it is a uniform thermal conductivity. Based on the value of KB. KB is written directly to be 0.8. So it is uniform KB. And it is a variable KB. And we have to solve and you have to get the value of rate of heat flow through this. So how we can calculate the rate of heat flow? Before getting the rate of heat flow, we can go with the T2 value. So how we can calculate the T2 here? Any idea? How we can proceed? We can proceed. First, we'll calculate the resistance part and then we can proceed with T2. So first we'll calculate the T2. So in order to calculate the T2, that is the temperature at layer interface. Temperature at layer interface. That is your T2 that we supposed to calculate. So first we'll calculate the thermal resistance RTH A for fire clay, then thermal resistance RTH B for red brick. So first we'll go with the mean thermal conductivity. What is mean thermal conductivity? So mean thermal conductivity for Ka mean that we are talking. So I can say Ka mean is equal to given to be 0.25 into 1 plus 0.0009 into T. So you can say T mean is equal to 1250 plus T2 divided by 2. That is your mean. That is the between the layer A. That is your KM. And then if you have to apply the thermal resistance, how you can say the thermal resistance of fire clay, thermal resistance for fire clay, that is your layer A. I can say RTH A is equal to L upon KA. So for layer A it will be LA and this will be your KA mean. Okay, this will be your LA mean. I can write as AA mean has to be here. Okay, now based on this, I can put the values. So, what is the LA? LA is 0.12, and what is KA? Area is 1, we can consider. So, KA is the entire part, like we can rewrite. Same part we can write as 0.25 into 1 plus 0.0009 into 1250 plus T2 divided by 2. And when we resolve it, what finally I can get RTHA, after resolving I can rewrite this as 1 upon, I can write as 2.083 plus 0.000937 into 1250 plus T2. So after resolving, I am getting the RTHA in terms of T2. I can go with RTHB. I can write thermal resistance of red brick. So for red brick, I can apply direct formula, that is for layer B. I can apply the formula for layer B. It is RTH B is equal to L upon K into A. So it is the layer B, LB and KB. I can apply the values. This 0.6, thickness is 0.6 divided by thermal conductivity is 0.8 into 1. So I will get 0.75. So I got the value of RTH A and RTH B. Now I can have the heat loss for furnace wall. So how I can write the heat loss of furnace wall? Heat loss of furnace wall. So I can apply the equation of heat loss. U is equal to delta upon summation of RTH. That is both the resistance. That is 1, 2, 50 minus 40 divided by RTH A plus RTH B. I hope it is understood how we got RTH A and RTH B referring to the problem. So how many resistance do we have here? We have a two resistance. There is nothing data given here. So we calculate the resistance as RTH A and RTH B. There is no data given outside of the air. So I can say it is RTH A, thermal conduction resistance, and thermal conduction resistance for RTH B. And I can say this is the amount of heat flow in this direction, positive x direction. And this we can apply, that is for T3 and this is for T2. The same we can apply here, summation of RTH A plus RTH B. Now, this we can conclude to be your number one, okay? Because RTH B it is in terms of temperature T2. RTH A we can apply the value and we can resolve, we cannot resolve it. So we can have number one because Q is unknown and RTH B is also unknown. So we can go with the other way. Heat flow through red brick only we can consider. If I consider heat flow through red brick. So if I do this, I can get the equation as Q is equal to T2 minus 4T divided by RTH B. And this RTH B, it is in terms of temperature T2. So instead of writing the values, either you can write the values if it's in terms of T2 or you can leave it as it is. And you can have the name as number 2. So number 1, RTH B is unknown in equation 1. Equation 2, RTH B is also unknown. And you can equate equation 1 and 2. So when you equate equation 1 and 2, that is from 1 and equation 2, you will get the value of RTH B. Are you getting me? You will get the value of RTH B as something. And after equating, I can just write the direct answer for you. After equating, you know RTH B formula. In both the equation, okay, T2 is also shown, so we cannot do it. We have to split the RTH B in terms of T2. So RTH B ko hum aise rakh nahi sakenge. RTH B, this LB upon KB. So RTH B, we have a value 0.75. RTH A is unknown in terms of T2. Okay, so we can apply the formula here and we can solve. We cannot go in this way. So we can solve this. So what will be your value for Q2? So I can write Q2 in terms of is equal to RTH B is known. Is it clear? But T2 is unknown. So RTH B it is in terms of 0.75. So this will be T2 minus 40 divided by RTH B we had calculated to be 0.75. Yeah, 0.75. So it will be equation number 2. And equation number 1 will also be in terms of temperature T2. Are you getting me? If you put the values of RTH B, so what is RTH B? It is 0.75. So if I rewrite this equation, so equation B may be aapko value mil jayega. So I can rewrite equation this as 1250 minus 40 and divided by RTH A is unknown. So RTH A, you can put the entire value of RTH A plus RTH B, it is 0.75. So I can put this, or you can resolve in terms of RTH A. So you can put the entire equation of RTH A 1 upon 2.03 plus this in terms of temperature T2. Okay. So if you want, you can write it for you and then you can equate it. So you can equate it. You can put the value as 1250 minus 40. Divided by RTH A. So So what is your RTH A? It is LA upon KA. So LA is 0.12 upon KA. So what is KA? KA is point. So we got RTH A as 1 upon 2 point. So directly we will write those things. We are already solved. I can write the value of RTH A. So I can write RTH A is equal to 1 upon it is 1 upon 2.083 plus 0.000937 into 1250 plus T2. This is your entire value of RTH B, and then you can put the value of RTH B here. Plus RTH B, which is 0.75. And now you can resolve this problem or this equation number 1 and equation number 2. So this is your equation number 1. Equation number 1, you can solve, and you can have in equation number, we can have a T2 as common, T2 is unknown, and equation number 2, again T2 is unknown. So you can equate from 1 and 2, you will get the value of RTH T2 directly instead of RTH. We got only one unknown in equation number 1 and equation number 2. So you can write the value.
Sir, RTH A mein 2.083 kaise aaya, wo cheez nahi samajh aa rahi.
It is after resolving RTH A mein. Okay, RTH A is 0.12 divided by 1.125, correct hai? तो फर्स्ट क्या करना है आपको, फर्स्ट क्या करना है, टू से डिवाइड करना है इसको. सो व्हेन यू डिवाइड दिस इट विल कम्स टू 0.0045. जो 9 है वो 45 हो जाएगा. तो आपका आंसर क्या हो जाएगा, इट विल बी 0.251 प्लस 0.0009 इनटू 1250 प्लस T2, बिकॉज यू हैव डिवाइडेड 0.009 डिवाइडेड बाय 2, ये 0.0045 हो जाएगा. ठीक है, एंड आफ्टर दैट यू कैन डिवाइड द एंटायर टर्म विद 0.12. जैसे कि आई वांट टू रिजॉल्व इट, अगर मुझे इसको रिजॉल्व करना है, हाउ आई कैन रिजॉल्व, आई कैन पुट इन दिस वे, इज इक्वल टू, आई कैन पुट 0.12 डिवाइडेड बाय, मुझे क्या करना है, 0.25 एज इट इज रखना है, इनटू 1 प्लस 0.00045 हो जाएगा, एंड देन ब्रैकेट विल बी लेफ्ट इज 1250 प्लस T2. ये ऐसे रहेगा. ठीक है, अगर फर्दर सिंप्लीफाई करना है तो क्या हो जाएगा, वो आई टू टेक 1 अपॉन समथिंग. तो मैं क्या करूँगा, उसको 1 अपॉन लेना है. सो आई विल टेक इट एज 1 अपॉन द एंटायर टर्म एज 0.25 इंटू 1 प्लस 0.0045 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1250 प्लस T2. दिस इज सिंपल कैलकुलेशन पार्ट दैट यू कैन रिफर इट. And then you can entire term, you can divide it by 0.12. So if you do this, you can easily have the, now if I divide this term with 0.12, you will get the value of 1 upon, are you getting me? I have taken, if you divide,
yes, sir, sound,
okay. If you divide the denominator, if you divide with 0.12, so the left part will be 1 upon something. So 1 upon something kya rahega? Ye rahega. 1 upon 2 point, if I multiply with this and divide by with this, so it will be 2.083 plus so and so. So aapka jo problem hai, it will more simplify in terms of T2. Humko T2 ko open karna hai. Are you getting me? So it will be in terms of T2. So RTHA is in terms of T2. So we got in equation 1, we have RTH A. Equation 1 में आपका RTH A आ जाएगा. Equation 1 किधर है आपका? Equation 1 इधर है. So we get RTH A is here. This is the equation number 1. So we have a T2 as the unknown part in the entire part. So आप इसको simplify करेंगे. Okay, आपका T2 ही ऐसे ही रहेगा. अब इसको चाहिए सिंपलीफाई कर लो, अदरवाइज आप इक्वेट कर लो डायरेक्टली कैल्सी में डाल के। इफ यू पुट इट डायरेक्टली कैल्सी, इक्वेशन वन इज इक्वल टू इक्वेशन टू। इक्वेशन टू में क्या है, टी टू इज अननोन है, इक्वेशन वन में क्या है, टी टू अननोन है। अब डायरेक्ट इसको इक्वेट करो, आफ्टर इक्वेटिंग यू कैन राइट डायरेक्ट आंसर ऑफ टी टू। सो फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन एंड टू आफ्टर सॉल्विंग यू कैन वेरीफाई योर सेल्फ, यू शुड हैव अ टेम्परेचर टी टू इज इक्वल टू 9.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस, आपको ये वैल्यू आना चाहिए। इज इट क्लियर? तो ये आपका टेम्परेचर एट द इंटरफेस हो गया। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट हीट लॉस, हीट लॉस फॉर 1 मीटर स्क्वेयर ऑफ फर्नेस वॉल, तो फर्नेस वॉल का एरिया दिया है 1 मीटर स्क्वायर। आई कैन टेक एनी फॉर्मूला ऑफ इक्वेशन वन एंड इक्वेशन टू, आइदर आई कैन गो, आई कैन पुट दी, आई कैन गो विद इक्वेशन नंबर टू। इक्वेशन नंबर टू लूंगा तो मुझे टी टू यहाँ पे मैं पुटअप करूंगा तो मुझे क्यू मिल जाएगा। आइदर आई कैन गो विद इक्वेशन नंबर वन, सो इक्वेशन टू इज मोर सिंपली फॉर्म, सिंपल फॉर मी, आई कैन गो विद इक्वेशन नंबर टू। आई कैन राइट द इक्वेशन टू एज क्यू इज इक्वल टू टी टू माइनस 40 डिवाइडेड बाय आर टी एच बी। तो आर टी एच बी का वैल्यू मुझे पता है 0.75 है, तो टी टू इज 955 माइनस 40 माइनस 40 डिवाइडेड बाय आर टी एच बी इज 0.75। सो इफ आई पुट दिस व्हाट आई विल गेट क्यू टू, इफ आई पुट दिस
1120 1220
या आई विल गेट 1220 1221 0.28 अप्रोक्सीमेट यहाँ तक आंसर आएगा आपको, दैट इज 1221 और 1220 कैन ऑल्सो बी कंसिडर बिकॉज ऑफ पॉइंट डिफरेंस। सो दिस इज द फाइनल वैल्यू ऑफ यू विल गेट हीट लॉस फॉर 1 मीटर स्क्वेयर ऑफ फर्नेस वॉल, दैट इज द क्यू पार्ट एंड इंटरफेस टेम्परेचर टी टू। ये दो आपको अनोन कैलकुलेट करना है। द प्रॉब्लम वॉज लेंदी, इट इज ओनली बिकॉज वी गॉट द प्रॉब्लम इन दिस वे, कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्म में आ गया था। ओके, so it is called a problem on layer A about having a thermal conductivity which was varying throughout the layer A, and for layer B thermal conductivity KB was uniform throughout the layer B. So in this way, if you can do the calculation, you can easily have a T2 and Q as unknown, you can calculate it. I hope it is clear. Now in this way you can proceed with your variable thermal conductivity problem.